Hello, everybody. My name is Invictad. Welcome back to the Lobotomy Corporation Season 5. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Now, you may notice a couple of things that might be different from this first episode that you saw yesterday. And we essentially had to restart the save file again. I know, as dumb as it sounds, I took the button at the end, right after yesterday's episode was recording. I was about to do a second episode, and I took the button and realized that you don't ever have to take the button ever. I only found that out after the fact, so unfortunately, it was on day 11, which is a memory repository day, which then means that I'm stuck with the button no matter what. And I am not, especially knowing that I don't have to take the button, I also have to take La Luna for the 100% completion, so that's awesome. And thank you all very much for pointing that out in the comments. But unfortunately, I did have to restart the save file. So you're going to see some things differently here. Namely, you're going to see a different abnormality. We did get Fragment of the Universe. Everything is mostly the same, except now we have this thing, which I believe is the singing machine, but I could be wrong about that. I think that's the name of this that we saw from season one. And I do know that this thing is capable of doing insta kills. So I'm not 100% entirely sure exactly, what we can work to this one. So that's why I'm bringing Husky here. So we may be throwing somebody into their doom for now, but hopefully not. Coach Krendor, do some attachment work. Blends, harmonize, melody. Yeah. So this is the singing machine. We saw this. I think we had this in the first impressions. It can't escape, but I know that it can, I don't know if it can charm people, but I do know that it can instantly kill people. And of course, we don't want that. So, I don't recall. I probably should have taken a look at the managerial preferences. I don't recall if this thing works off of a stat requirement or not. Truth be told, I don't even remember what we're supposed to be doing. I think attachment's okay. Let me see. So let's watch here. I remember we had this problem with the singing machine the only time we've seen it. It deals white damage. Later became sick. Now Coach has gone cuckoo for Coach-O puffs. Yeah, we're gonna need, do we have anyone that actually deals white damage? Force does. Force is the only one. Force, we need you to handle Coach. that's a very Coach Krendor like face right there. Force. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, stop him. There we go. All right, he's better. Okay, so we got 9 points. The employee with level 4 or more fortitude. Oh, or the employee with level 2 or less. Okay, so we can't send anyone there with Fortitude 4 or higher, or Temperance 2 or less. Fortitude 4 or higher, Temperance 2 or less. Krendor took so much damage because he's weak to white damage thanks to the Amida armor, but Force can do it. Kurt can also do it. Kurt's actually more resistant to it than he is, and he has the right Kurt has the right requirements, so this should be okay for Kurt. Okay, and we didn't have to kill Krendor, so that's good. Okay, so I knew that there was a stat requirement. It's been a little bit since we've seen the singing machine, but he got a bad result. So the Klivov counter must mean that it's okay, because Krendor also got a bad. Okay. All right, so the Klivov counter for the singing machine must be 2. Krendor got it down to 1, and then Kurt. Okay, so attachment is not the thing to work on this thing at all. In fact, I'm going to put Kurt down here. We really don't need Husky down here, but whatever. Let's see if that prediction is true. Okay, so maybe we can do instinct on it. Thank you, Matty Ice, for the tier 1 sub. Okay. Okay, so speed rate plus 4. Work resolve bad, Klivov counter is reduced. We kind of knew that. Klivov counter reads 0. The employee who entered the containment room dived into it. When the machine was working, one of the nearby employees complained that she could hear the sound of a continuous melody coming from nowhere. We decided to call this phenomenon Bewitched. Employee Alex fainted after being attacked by employee JJ. After attack, JJ made unconscious Alex get sucked into the... Okay. So we cannot allow anyone to die to this thing. But instinct seems to be what it likes, so. There we go on that. Okay. Maynard, let's get my attachment up. Husky needs to do something. Husky's fine. Thank you, Rackshire, for the sub as well. I am, those of you on YouTube, I am obviously recording this on Twitch. But as I said on yesterday's episode, I'm not going to be, I'm going to be making sure all the alerts and stuff are turned off. Okay, so that one's doing good here. Yeah, instinct is definitely the way to go. But the only problem is, well, I guess we can... What we should do is we should just get to full observation level here, and then we can just ignore it forever. Yeah, this is gonna, we're gonna get the Red Dawn here. Actually, we need to slow our roll because Red Dawn. Well, no, Red Dawn's nothing special. Here you go, Baynard. Baynard, you can get Red Dawn started, and I'll take care of it all. Costco has genuine Wagyu? I didn't know that. I've never been to Costco. I know that there's one somewhere around here. Hello, Rocky Banana as well. Thank you for the sub. It'd be a good time to mention to the YouTube audience, for those of you who do want to see these episodes recorded live, and you get to catch a lot of the other stuff that isn't captured on the recordings, then definitely come on by the Twitch channel. We have a lot of fun. Okay, Kurt, I'm going to keep doing that. Coach is there. It's definitely a whole different tier of steak. Dude, I'm so there. All right, Force is there. Punishing Bird. I want to get some more Fortitude. No, I know there's a Costco in Texas. I'm just saying, I've never been there. My parents go to Costco all the time. I've never been there. I didn't know that they carried Wagyu, though. Pretty awesome. I know that we can do repression on Fragment. See, Krendor already got the payout. That's right. Okay. We're just going to keep spamming this for Kurt. Oof. That looks like Rodalta's eyes. Am I mistaken, or is this the same eyes that Rodalta has? I wonder if there's a connection there. Uber Bird's out. Who cares? Husky will try to get the heart there. Kurt, you're doing an awesome job with Singing Machine. Keep it up. And now that we have all the lore here, the machine takes the shape of a long cuboid. By the look of it, it may look like a simple grinder, but the existence of the thing's own will fills the criteria of an abnormality. When approached, extra experiments are needed to determine how many meters of the perimeter actually is. Or touched, the employees put their bodies into the abnormality. Afterwards, the machine fan shuts, and the abnormality works on the task. The task approximately takes 5 minutes. After a few experiments we've concluded that the abnormality desires the result of music from this interaction. There's no detailed research of the music. However, there's a hypothesis that the music has a special characteristics that attracts people based on the specific behavior of some employees or the psychological counseling record. If an employee is determined to be addicted to the music, they will need to be treated quickly to prevent any secondary damage to that employee may cause. Excerpt from interview log. Oh my goodness. I was supposed to be sent in alone. The abnormality looked rather unassuming. Something like a machine used in a factory, as it didn't react to anything. But that day, blank insisted that we go there. He kept on saying that the pale horse has responded to him. I didn't think pale horse was thinking about me when it responded. Most of the abnormalities that I take care of are safe. Also, I'm very lucky. I thought that day would be the same. Omitted. Redacted closely observed the abnormality. I just wanted to write the report quickly and get out, but he was thinking differently. He was sure that there wouldn't be an abnormality that doesn't have special powers. I warned him not to get too close, but Redacted took one step closer. And suddenly the thing came to life, opened its lid and swallowed him whole. Literally swallowed him. The lid closed and a loud noise came from the inside of the creature. There was no way of knowing what was happening, but I was too terrified to do anything. Omitted. In the dark, I realized that the thing was playing an instrument. By crushing and cutting Redacted's body, it was creating a melody. As I was contemplating my horrific realization, the lid opened again. Bits and pieces of Redacted were in there. So little that you had to wonder what happened to the rest. Omitted. Must read. Symptoms of intoxication by the singing machine. Attempts to take other employees to the containment chamber of the singing machine by using physical force. The size of the pupils are enlarged. Concentration, cognitive ability are greatly reduced. Does not try to listen to other music. Please add any additional symptoms that are found and immediately report the case if any employees are suspected of the above symptoms. Excerpt from incident log. On the year of XXXX, the day of XX, there is a disappearing incident of an employee M1840. 2 days later, on the XX, part of the body was found inside of the singing machine. DNA analysis had found the corpse to be employee of... That employee was a new hire who worked for the company for only 3 months. The employee had no record of assignment with the abnormality. The employee assigned to the singing machine, Redacted, was the suspect. After an extensive investigation, Redacted confessed to the crime. I know it's crazy, but I had to hear that music again. I couldn't get it out of my head for months. I performed all kinds of experiments. When the machine takes in a cat, it plays for 1 minute. A large dog, 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Redacted music came from it. But nothing was like the music it makes when it eats a human. It might sound ridiculous, but I feel satisfied having heard it once more. I do not remember that weapon, but... Oh boy. Good old Lobotomy Corporation, always there to brighten your day. Kurt, you're doing a bang-up job. I'm pretty sure we won't ever need the weapon from it, but we might as well get one. Husky still needs that. Kurt's going to get a huge fortitude buff, that's for sure. I'm happy with that. War Strategy Gaming, get some of the repression work done. So we'll go to day 10. We'll go to Meltdown level 10 on this. We've already gotten the full observation level on it, so there's no reason for us to keep going back in here. Unless we have someone who's like 3 fortitude, that we just want to get them more HP. Then I'm okay with that. Thank you, Soul 11010. Glad to hear that it helped. Thank you very much for watching them. Okay, Husky got the heart. Good. Okay, I'm going to go back to working on Stupid Bird. Baynard can get some SP. The meta goal for Season 5 of Lobotomy Corporation will be to get as many abnormalities that we've never seen before fixed. Luckily, I do know what La Luna looks like, so I know that, and I also know that we can completely avoid that abnormality completely. So, you know, just trying to fill out the codex to 100%. We'll get down to the line. If there's still more that we need, then we'll restart and go again. Although I will say that most likely if we end up going restarting for a third time, I probably won't record most of that. Coach can go back there. Force. Baynard really needs to work his fortitude. So we'll finish this. We'll finish out this meltdown level, and then that'll be it. Kurt's gonna have Kurt's gonna have tons of fortitude after this. Big coach, keep it safe. Let Baynard finish it up. As soon as Baynard is done, that'll be it. And I will let Force can come down here and work with Fragment. There we go. Okay, so we have our three weapons from the singing machine if we ever need to use them, which we won't. As soon as Baynard's done, that'll be it. Did Kurt get a payout from that thing? Does he even have any gifts? 8% chance. Harmony. When attacked by white damage, recovery 20% of the damage and plus 10 attack speed. Wow. Kurt did not get that. 8% chance. Not all that surprising. Big time gains for everybody. What did Kurt go to? He went from 3 to 5. Holy smokes. Yo, Singing Machine is the way to go. I mean, it is an HE class, so. Let's see who we get. No, thank you. Spider-Bud's back. We could get Spider-Bud. Leticia. Leticia's also not terrible. Spider-Bud was pretty good for training up Fortitude, if I recall correctly. Beauty and the Beast is good for repression. Leticia is good for attachment and insight, but she has the insta-kill of the heart. So I'm going to go Spider-Bud here. Especially since, like, we had Spider-Bud the last time, that before we had to reset due to the button. So we can send Baynard down to work with Spider-Bud. Force and Sinvicta can stay up in the control team. Yeah, there's Spider-Bud. Yeah, Baynard needs to work on his fortitude, and we need to hire somebody else too. Okay, so the next up for the hire, we got Force, we got Baynard. You know, we gotta get Tangsock. Tangsock, is he changing? You think he's gonna change his do for season 5? He probably would. He's been rocking the dreads for 2 seasons now. He would probably switch it up. Tangsock. He's going. No, he wouldn't go for the emo look. He's going messy. He's going just Tank Sock's going full on messy this season. Tank Sock, the freaking superstar, man. There we go. Looking good. Battle face. Hurt those teeth. There we go. All right, Tang Sok, welcome back. We could probably put him down there to work with the Singing Machine, actually. That'd be a way to supercharge his growth. But for now, we'll keep it there. All right, let's get him situated. Is Husky strong enough to use Aleph yet? No, he needs fortitude and prudence. Let's see, Husky. There we go. All right, Husky's strong enough to use Aleph now. Good. Good. So that's two Aleph geared workers that we have. And we're pretty much back to where we started before we had to reset. Okay, Tang Sok. You need to be strong to white. We'll give him hypocrisy. Yeah, red damage. Sounds good. Coach Krendor, I'm actually going to take him off of Amida and put him with hypocrisy as well. I want him to be able to work with that. Baynard's next in line for the upgrades. But he needs to work on his fortitude. Okay. So Spider Bud. Okay, so Baynard should be able to work. It's 4 and 2. Yeah, so he should be able to work Instinct with the Singing Machine. And then Krendor can work Instinct with Spider Bud. Hurt can get attachment work done. Force can go there. I can continue to work on my fortitude, and Tang Sok can start working with One Bro. Yeah, there we go. Good, this is all good. Well, I like to see everyone. Why? Level 2 or less, dives in the same machine to operate after clean work. What? Anar doesn't have 2 or less. And he doesn't have 4 fortitude. He's got 3 fortitude and 4 temperance. Why was he thrown in there? That doesn't make any sense, game. He didn't get a bad. Four or more fortitude dives into the singing machine to operate after completing the work. He doesn't have 4. Level 2 or less temperance dives into the singing machine to operate after completing work. There should be no reason why Baynard can't do this. He's got 4 temperance and 3 fortitude. That's well below the cutoff. And he didn't get bad. Yeah, what the heck? That made absolutely no sense. I didn't do anything differently that I did last time. That makes absolutely no sense. M- My only guess is that he was given the ego gift, and that put him over his HP to the threshold of 4. That's the only guess that I can offer is that he got the ego gift on the first payout, and then that was enough to trigger the insta death. That's the only thing that I can think of. Horse needs to work on that. I can work with one bro. So if this thing's fortitude ego gift pays out, it can insta kill, and that's not worth it. 8% chance to die in there. So that's unfortunate, but what can you do? Okay, Maynard. Coach Krendor needs to work on that. I will let Tang Sok go there. Let's see. Horse, why don't you try working Instinct on Megahertz? I want to see how well it works. There we go. Okay, attachment work. The Banar can do that. Instinct. He got 7 on that. That's good enough to train. I'm down for it. It might lower the cliff off counter, but we can get that back up by just getting a good. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure why it would do that. But that's the only thing that makes sense, even though it doesn't make sense. I mean, it's dumb that it makes sense, but we can do attachment on Spider Bud. And we can do attachment as well, but Coach Krendor needs instinct. Yeah, and Force got it good. So yeah, so we totally can work instinct on a Megahertz. That's really good. Tang Sok's come over here to work with Fragment. Well, I'm glad that I took Spider Bud because we really needed. It's a shame that our first HE is too volatile. It's too much of a risk. I can't put anyone in there. Not worth it. Yeah, most likely we won't be taking Queen of Hatred or Magical Girl. We already have seen everything that they had to offer, so there's no reason for us to take it. Horse, I'll go ahead and send. That Tang Sok should be able to handle that. I also can't ignore Husky either. We need to make sure Husky's getting his fortitude work on. Again, we'll go to Meltdown level 10. Yeah, Tang Sok did a good job. He did lower the club counter by 1, but that's okay. No one's perfect, Tang Sok, except for Baynard. Insight. Let Force do that. And right now, we're just skilling up all of their HP. We want as much HP as possible, obviously. And if we can get Baynard kitted out in his blue star gear quick, that would be nice. Silent Orchestra is most certainly not a bro. Under no condition. Force do that. Think so I can go there. We'll finish off this day and that'll be good. And we'll let Kurt finish it off. Now it is possible the fragment might get out here, so we'll see. As soon as Baynard is done, we'll be done. We'll be done, Dizzle. Wait for Baynard. Okay, Baynard's done. Husky's done. Baynard's done now. Waiting for Kurt. Okay, everyone's good. We're Gucci. Nothing's escaped. Good. Okay, got some more gains for people. One bro really, really isn't paying out with anything. Husky got a minimal gain. Good gains by Baynard. Four strategy gaming is to rank 5. Look at the stat ups. Well, I mean, not great stat ups, but still. Tang Sai getting some stats. That's what I'm talking about. All right, who do we got? We need some good. We need some VOBs or some Teths or something. Not Teths. HEs. Behavior adjustment, Teresa. Probably the skin. This is going to be the tool day. Yep. Yes, Teresa. So today's going to be basically more of the same. And again, I'm gonna try to keep these episodes pretty short and sweet if I can. Who was it that reached rank 5? Force? No, stop this. He's almost there. Okay, if we can get Force to get ready for the next Aleph, Force will be able to ascend here. So Force needs to work exclusively on instinct. Tang Sok can do whatever. I'm gonna keep working with one bro just because. Baynard's HP didn't go up as much as I would like it to. Heart of Aspiration can kill you, yes. It is capable of killing. Let's get Baynard's instinct back up. I'm gonna keep spamming instinct for Force. See about this. Yeah, that's what I thought. And we'll go ahead and bring a quick end to that. Thanks. Oh my god, Baynard got the glasses. Typical Baynard getting payouts like immediately. Insight. Let's see if Coach can handle insight. I do like the glasses, Baynard. They look good on you. Yeah, Coach was able to handle it. It was all right. And I mean, if Fragment gets out, oh no. You know? Oh no, Fragment of the Universe is out. Whatever will we do? Not like we can just two-shot him with Husky. All right, let's see. Kurt, I would like to see you go over 100. Same goes for Husky, actually. Probably going to take it down to a 1 here because we got a neutral. Yep. So, Fragment may breach next turn. Which, again, is not a real big deal. Husky will just lay the smackdown on him, and that'll be it. Insight. Good job, Coach. Coach got a good. Fragment still might breach, though, I think. Nope. Just let Kurt get a swing in there. Kurt needs to work on his SP some. We're just farming the good stuff. Calm before the storm. I love flying through these early days here. Just getting the big gains. We definitely need another HE, though. Good up, Kurt. It's a shame that we can't work. That really sucks that the mechanic works like that. It's kind of dumb, if you ask me, that the ego gift can possibly push you over the fortitude while you're inside of the containment unit. And insta-kill you is really quite dumb. Because that's a waste. Like, we could have gotten something else instead of the singing machine, but we needed to get it for the codex, so I guess it's not that big of a deal, but it still kind of sucks. That should be enough to take Force. So once Force is done, I think that we'll call it here. Oh no, Fragment escaped. And he's back. There we go. Everyone's good. Everyone's out. Good, good, good. All right. Did Force get to rank 5 on Fortitude? He didn't. Wow. I can't believe he didn't make it rank 5. All right. We're back where we last left off now. Day 10. Oh, Angela. I think that's a good time to end this one, but we're going to be doing more of these longer episodes here. I know that this one wasn't quite as long as the first one, but remember, I'm trying to play catch up here as well, and having to do this again over and over again is not that fun. So the next episode you may see, we may be a couple days down the road. For YouTube, I don't think it's really all that imperative that you guys and gals see this. Again, if you're interested in learning about the game, if you're learning for the, if you want to learn just like the mechanics or the story or anything like that, then again, I highly recommend you check the link down below in the description that takes you to episode 1 of season 3 because I go over all of that. So check the description if you're looking for it. If you want to learn about Lobotomy Corporation, it is absolutely worth your time to learn it. I wouldn't have done 5 episodes of the game if I didn't think that it was good for YouTube, but I think it's very good for YouTube. So definitely go check it out. Try to avoid spoilers in the comments. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your support on Season 5 of Lobotomy Corporation. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.